Hey guys, literally my last video was me being excited about my new hair color, about this beautiful orange copper awesomeness. Well, it's about that time where my roots are growing in and I start to get a little indecisive about things. Before I decide to change my mind and do something totally different again, I want to go through a pros and cons list of having dyed red hair. Like, a few of these might actually be relatable to natural redheads. You'll see what I'm talking about. So the way I'm gonna do this is one pro, one con. I'm gonna go back and forth. I have six pros and six cons. First pro to having red hair or copper hair, orange hair, whatever color you wanna call it, is that I've never gotten this many compliments on any color I've ever had before, not even gray, which is crazy to me because that's the one that takes the most work. I've been getting lots of attention lately. 99.999% of the attention has been good attention and people have been complimenting me. It's been really nice. I've been flattered every day. For a con, going off of the attention aspect of this, sometimes a very, very, very small percentage of that attention is not bad. It's not against the hair color. It's just people being weird. For an example, today at work, I helped a guy find something. He was probably in his 70s. And after I helped him find what he needed, he said, "Good girl." And then I was like, ugh, that's just weird, first of all. But then he went on to say, "You have orange hair and you're still a good girl." I was like, what's that supposed to mean? That part right there is the part where I was like, okay, maybe natural redheads can relate to this because I guess everyone just assumes you're sassy or feisty just because your hair is reddish. So stupid. So the next pro is that it looks really cool. So it's not necessarily a common hair color. It's really fun actually to have this hair color. I don't have any complaints towards this color in particular. Another con though would be that it fades so freaking fast. This is not my original first application. This is the second one. There might be some kind of conditioner that you can color seal with, but I like to use a conditioner that's more so focused on strengthening and thickening my hair because it's been through a lot and I'm about to put it through even more, but whatever. So another pro would have to be that it's fun to style. So when you have a new hair color and it's bright and vibrant like this is, it's fun to like try new things with your hair, like doing different braids, doing different updos, doing different downdos. The other day I crimped my hair and I totally looked like the girl from Brave. Another con that I have kind of piggybacks off of the last con I had, being that it fades fast. It takes lots of maintenance. As I was saying, since it fades fast, you have to touch it up quite often. So the healthier the hair, the longer the color lasts on your hair. As you can tell, some parts of my hair are more healthy, some parts of my hair are a bit frazzled. That's the best word I could come up with right now. Frizzled, frazzled, whatever. The parts that are not that healthy end up looking yellowish, which is fine. But I know that if I took like three more showers, my hair would look really strange. Like closer to my roots would be really orange and scarlet colored, while the ends of my hair would be pretty much blonde and it would be kind of weird. I mean, some hairstyles that looks amazing with, like a balayage or an ombre, but this would just look weird. So another pro I have, it is a good fall color. This is the most festive fall color you can imagine, right? It'd be a perfect time to do it now, live it up in October with this orange hair, and then if you want to change your mind after that, you can, but it's not a huge commitment because it comes out easily. So you know what? Even if you have it just for the fall, that's fine. It comes out like that. So another con would be that anytime you walk into the rain or you sweat a little bit or you get your hair wet, a lot of the color bleeds out. That kind of plays into it fading because it just doesn't want to stay in your hair. Now another pro I have, having this color means that you need to switch up what you wear in your wardrobe if you care a lot about color coordination. And I like having challenges and trying to come up with new outfit ideas. So this to me is more exciting than it being a disadvantage. So the last con I have, which is actually one of the biggest reasons as to why I don't want red hair anymore, is that since it does bleed when it gets wet or anything, it gets all over your stuff. So your shower is gonna be orange and shit on the bottom near the drain, and possibly your shower curtain, and also your pillow, and your jackets, your shirts, you name it. It's gonna turn orange. Even if you lay on your boyfriend's shoulder and he has a light colored shirt, guess what? His shoulder's gonna be orange. So just be cautious about that if you decide to do a red semi-permanent color. And the last pro that I have is that it's a conversation starter. Being that it gets lots of attention and lots of people compliment it, it ends up turning into a conversation, either about being excited for fall, that color looks great on you, what brand did you use, Arctic Fox, oh I love Arctic Fox. The best conversation I've had yet was with a really old couple. They weren't really old, but they were pretty old. The guy came up to me, I already acknowledged this in my how I got this color. So this couple came up to me at work and they were like, that hair color is so beautiful. It is so orange and vibrant. My wife, she used to dye her hair all the time. She did all sorts of colors. I love it. And then I was like, oh, that's so sweet that this old couple is all about some hair dyeing. It was adorable. The lady and I had a pretty good conversation about all the colors that she's done and all the colors that I've done, which is pretty much everything. Both of us, not together, separately, we've both done about everything. I don't know if this video made it any harder or easier for you to decide whether or not you're going to do this color or any red color. It just depends on how much you want it. For me right now, I'm leaning more towards the con side only because I'm indecisive as okay, I love how it looks. I just wish this color could naturally come out of my head so I wouldn't have to go with the upkeep and all that stuff. But it's perfect for a temporary color. For me personally, a tip that I think is very helpful is to wear black a lot in case your hair color decides to come out somehow or rub up against your jacket and get all over it. And then I also got black pillowcases because, yeah, you're gonna want some black pillowcases if you dye your hair a lot. Forgot to say, it for sure gets on your towels. And if you have a white towel, you're in for a treat. I know you guys are probably shaking your head because I'm already dyeing my hair again, something different when I just got so excited about this color. And I've done red before. I knew about all of the responsibilities with red hair, but I kind of forgot how much work it would be. Thank you guys so much for watching, and if you have any questions, please comment below. And if you want to subscribe, that would be amazing. I'm a whack job. You know what I think would be funny? If I did an ASMR video. I know a lot of people find it very relaxing.